As a man, you have to learn to live with loss. I'm 55 now, and I've learned there are so many forms of loss in our lives. The loss of health. I eat right. I'm active and have reasonable genetics. Yet the ever-increasing loss of my youthful energy and body is at times the stuff of tears. Oscar Wilde said it best, youth is wasted on the young. Yet day by day, I find a way to appreciate my body. It no longer has to meet societal standard. My weight, my scars, the wrinkles and graying hair are the roadmaps of who I am. The loss through disconnecting is deep, but we can learn to think of that important loved one with affection and through memories. This is the loss between you and those that have lost a loved one have to deal with. I never knew I could breathe again. Looking at my mother's lifeless body, how can the breast that nurtured and nourished me in this world be no more? They are still in the world, just not yours. This is the truth for three of my family members and a few friends. I had to learn to let go. I miss them. I miss the times we shared, but I've got to accept we each walk our own path and there are many forks in it. Most of us have become perfect strangers in each other's lives. The virus has given people a reason to be aloof and stop caring, let alone loving. Don't be that person. The loss of dreams has been the deepest, especially for us men. We live with expectations. Few of us will reach a point that we exist even without them. While I have modified my current ones and I'm actively watching out for potential ones, those dreams in my past remain bittersweet. I was to be the first in many things for my family. Not achieving those dreams doesn't mean that I give up on life. My siblings look at me with questionable eyes, but deep I know now that what my youth never suspected. Being a firstborn means a parent for your siblings in waiting. Dreams that are buried in your heart while alive will kill you. The certainty in my heart that my mother and I will grow old best friends. But hey, Sir God had other plans for us. My amazing mother spent her last 2 years lost to cancer. I was able to accept what her disease was doing. As it had slowly progressed, I made small adjustments in and outside my life. At the very end, I was grateful that she no longer lived in pain and fear. All of these losses truly made me who I am today. There are chapters in my life that I keep on flipping through. I'm grateful that despite the pain, they tempered me. I am grateful that I've been inflicted. Every day, together with the people that I love, gives us chances to express our love and how we feel. That the tragedy will lay in not taking every opportunity to hug, to kiss, and hold hands. You can never tell another you love them too much. And the utter conviction. We have loved one before, and if it takes 100 years, we will find each other again. It is painful and more bitter than death when you lose those that are still alive in your life. Love deeply, care honestly, love more. Because the truth is, there is no much bigger pain than those people in your life that miss the love that you have in your heart, but they don't know it because you don't tell them. And most of us men are like that. We love the women in our lives. We love our kids. We love our friends. We love our colleagues. But we always just assume that they know how we feel. Don't deny them the love in your heart by keeping quiet, because you can never ever receive the love that has never been expressed. Tell them that you love them. I love you.